Hello friends, welcome back. Before this video I have discussed about the generation of impulse voltage. In this video I will discuss about the generation of high AC voltage. As we all know that during the high voltage transmission or extra high voltage or ultra high voltage transmissions, several electrical devices are connected, like transformer, insulators, or there are several other equipments also. So before installing those devices in the EHV or UHV transmission lines, those equipments should be properly tested, otherwise they will not work satisfactorily in this transmission. So for testing purpose we need to generate high voltage in the lab so that those instruments can be properly tested at the rated voltage. So due to this reason we need generation of AC voltage in the lab. So there are different methods which are being used to generate high AC voltage. There are three methods: cascaded transformer, resonant transformers and Tesla coil. In this video I will discuss about the cascaded transformers, and in upcoming two videos I will discuss about the resonant transformers and Tesla coil. So when test voltage requirements are less than 300 kV, then in that case a single transformer can be used for the testing purpose. Means a single transformer can generate up to 300 kV. But if the testing requirement is more than 300 kV, as we are having in the EHV or UHV lines, in that case single transformer will not be sufficient. So the reason behind that, a single unit construction becomes difficult and its cost is also high. And another issue is the insulation problem. Designing a transformer for more than 300 kV, that will be designing a device which can generate more than 300 kV, so it will create insulation problem. So, and another issue is that the transportation and assembly or large assembly of large transformers is also difficult. So these drawbacks can be overcome by series connection, or another name is known as cascading. So several identical transformers are connected in series. In the series connection means high voltage winding of all the units are connected in series. So this is the circuit diagram, connection diagram. You can see that in this connection diagram there is one transformer, it is first secondary of first transformer, this is secondary of second transformer, and this is secondary of third transformer. And you can see clearly that these all secondaries, high voltage windings, these are connected in series. So the output voltage will be the sum of these three. Now how this output voltage will be like this? This is first stage, this is second stage, and this is third stage. So in first stage you can see this is the applied voltage. The secondary of this applied voltage, the secondary of this first stage transformer is this. This secondary is connected in series with the secondary winding of second stage transformer, and this is the third stage. So secondary of third stage transformer is connected in series with this second stage. Another point of observation is that here this it at first stage this transformer is having three windings, primary, secondary and tertiary or auxiliary winding. The input of this auxiliary output of this auxiliary winding is given as input to second stage transformer, and this second stage transformer is also having a tertiary winding or auxiliary winding, and output of this auxiliary winding is given as input to third stage transformer. Only third stage is having two winding transformer, otherwise first and second, these two stages transformers are three stage transformer. Now when we are getting output of this stage one, then we will get the output voltage, this will be V. If we are getting the output across this, then this output voltage will be 2V, and if we are measuring the voltage between this and this terminal, in that case output voltage will be 3V. Here P, this P shows the loading of each transformer. Since this is here, voltage is thrice of input voltage, so and current will be same in this all three secondaries. Current will be I. So if voltage is thrice of this input voltage and current is I, so in primary winding of first stage transformer current will be thrice. So this first stage transformer is three times loaded, second stage transformer is two times loaded, and third stage transformer is carrying current I. So this P shows the loading. Now in this case, if we will go to the equivalent circuit of one stage, then this will be the equivalent circuit of a single stage. This is primary current, this is primary impedance, secondary current, primary turns and secondary turns, and this is for tertiary, ZT, IT and NT. Now if we will combine all three, first stage, second stage and third stage, then this will give us the equivalent circuit of all three stage transformer. Here it is also clear that the secondaries of all three transformers are connected in series, and this will be the simplified equivalent circuit. Now this is the explanation which I have already explained to you. It consists of high voltage and low voltage winding, then meter winding to measure the output voltage. The primary of first stage transformer is connected to low voltage supply, and the voltage is available across the secondary of this transformer. The tertiary winding or excitation winding of first stage has the same number of turns as the primary winding, and then potential of tertiary is fixed to the potential of voltage of secondary winding. Now the next point is secondary winding of second stage transformer is connected in series with secondary winding of first stage, so the output voltage will be 2V. Then similarly stage 3 is connected in series with second stage, so all three secondaries are connected in series, so output voltage will be 3V. And another point which is mainly required to be noted, that the all individual stages except uppermost, means except third stage, are three winding transformer, and only upper stage is having two winding transformer. So and the number of stages in this type of arrangement may be 2 to 4, but generally 3 stages are adopted, and the figure is already shown in the previous slide. Then another alternate arrangement for this may be the cascading through isolation. In this case you can see that there are 3 isolation transformer, IS1, IS2 and IS3. And the same input, this is V1, This is given to all three isolation transformers, and similarly connections to transformer T2 and T3 can be given, and we will get the output at output terminals. And isolation transformers are having 1:1 ratio, and the disadvantage of this isolation transformer scheme is that this scheme is expensive and requires more space. And there are some advantages of this scheme, that natural cooling will be sufficient for this scheme. Transformers are light and compact, easy transportation. The construction is identical for isolating transformers and high voltage cascade units. Thanks for watching the video. In the next video, I will discuss about the resonating transformers.